Buongiorno! Oh, I hate it when I say that. That sounds so bad. Welcome guys, welcome to a new video. My hair looks a bit funky, but we're in Portofino. We are celebrating our 15th anniversary here. I am so excited. So Mar organized this entire trip. Like, we have a tennis lesson tonight, we have boat day tomorrow, the day after is our anniversary, I'm guessing we're going to dinner, and it's just so nice. The other day he was organizing everything and I looked at him and I was like, do you actually enjoy organizing this? And he was like, yeah. And I was like, how is that possible? But great. It means that I don't have to do it, but it's just so cute. We're staying at like this super crazy dream place. Like, it's literally, the view is literally as if I'm looking at a painting. It's so crazy. I'm gonna show you. So how is this real? This is like I'm dreaming or something. It's just so crazy. And then this is the tennis court. This is probably the craziest tennis court I've ever seen. So the other day I was talking to a friend and she's single. And I'm like, babe, you have to find someone. And she said to me, she said, Negin, believe me, if you didn't have Mao, you would still be single. Meaning it's so hard to find someone that you're so connected to. And I believe that. I think if I didn't have Mao, it would have been difficult. But of course, it's hard to say, but he's just, and it's so cliche, but I honestly think he's my soulmate. I think so. Where is he? But it is. I think so, yeah, for sure. I mean, I think the way the bond we have together is just so unique, and it's, so thankful for him. I'm just so excited to be spending these days here. So I'm gonna show you my look real quick and then we're gonna go. So excited to be here! Wow, we just were at this beautiful spot. Look at this. Wait. Gonna show you a little bit better. It's so beautiful. Look at this. There's a special corner everywhere. You just have to be willing to walk a lot of stairs up and down, which we are, because now we haven't worked out, so it's fine. We arrived at the cutest beach place. It's a part of our hotel, but look at this setup. I'm going to show you. Oh. Like with the orange towels and then this situation. This is so beautiful. It's like we're in a movie. Mao, isn't it like we're in an Italian movie?
Yeah.
Like, and there's the like a handsome actor and I fall in love with this guy.
Am I the handsome actor?
Okay, I'm ready for tennis. I'm wearing these shorts that I love a lot because it's got like a biker short underneath and then this on top. I got it in Ibiza. I'll put the brand name here as usual. And then this top. Wish I had this entire look in white. That would be even nicer for tennis, but that's fine. I just took my makeup off. I had a shower. I feel fresh after the beach and I'm excited for tennis. I need to do a warm up because I don't want to be very sore yet tomorrow, especially since I haven't tennis for a while. So okay, this view is crazy. I'm gonna try to maybe create a fun time lapse over here, but it's kind of hard. This is so fun, you guys. basicest court, tennis court I've ever seen in my life. Good morning! We are getting ready for boat day. I really wanted to show you guys real quickly something, because as if this doesn't give me the feeling enough that I'm in a movie, this does. Like, where do you see the setup like this? It's so adorable. I just feel like I'm in a movie when I get ready here. So I do my hair, my makeup here, and it's just so fun. Wait, I have to turn this around. That was our new Gizu product, by the way. I'm not able to show it to you guys yet, but it's gonna be so good. Comment down below if you have any idea, any guesses what it is. It's a hair product, of course. It's not one of the limited edition items like we did for the jumpsuit or the carry-all bags. But it's so good. I'm gonna give you one tip. I use it after the shower on wet hair personally. Oh, can't wait for you to finally see it, because I've been using it for the longest time and I can't show it to you. But yeah, setup is right here. I already put my curler on because I'm gonna curl my hair. And yeah. Dior unboxing by himself.
This guy.
Not himself.
First bag. Oh, nice.
Oh, nice. For the boat.
Oh,
this
cool.
Is a towel, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Boat day.
How did they? It literally arrived the morning of our boat day. Did they know that we were going on a boat, or is this a coincidence?
I think it's a coincidence.
Crazy.
Okay, this is one towel.
Oh, I love.
I love.
Another towel?
Yeah.
Oh, this is one of those things that you put like a poncho.
No, that's a towel.
No, but Mao, here, look. You put your head here. See?
Oh, nice.
Yeah. This is super nice. Oh, yes.
Oh, this is for the end of the day.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Literally everything you need for boat day. This is amazing. This is really, really cool. Mao always hopes that there's something in him for him. Well, he once got this shirt from Dior, and it's like his favorite shirt because quality is so nice, the fit is so good, right?
Yeah.
And this is another towel. Oh, I am obsessed. This is like the best thing ever, right?
Yeah, we can take this with us.
Yes, cool. So we're meeting up with Mao's youngest brother, actually. They were doing a road trip through Italy and they were in the neighborhood. So we met up for boat day. They're joining us. And first we invited them for breakfast here at the hotel as well, because it's so magical. We wanted them to see it too. So I'm excited for today. This is the buffet. And because of COVID, we're standing here and they're getting us everything, but this is the most beautiful buffet I've ever seen. I am obsessed with this bikini! How cute! I love the print and then the two different colors. It's so nice. And the back is very nice too here. I love it! So we are on the boat now. We didn't pick out the best day because it's very windy today. We've got some big waves. And lately I've been a bit more sensitive to getting seasick. Oh, I love your shorts, Mao. We're matching in a way.
Hola.
Good shorts. So I've been getting a little bit more seasick, so I hope I'll be fine. But yeah, we're excited to look at this view.
Oh, this big.
Thank you.
I don't know if you could tell from the footage, but it was so windy, the waves were so big, yeah. So we're going back.
Stay back.
We're gonna, we're gonna go back and we're gonna go to the beach, so it's a pity, but this is just bad luck for today.
Yeah.
Mauritz is feeling very seasick.
Because then we go.
So bye bye boat day.
How do you feel?
Oh, am I being filmed? Is this the right time to be filmed? It was because I went inside. I went inside the boat and he was just calling his work. He was just having a Zoom call.
Had jij was hier echt een Zoom call?
Yeah. He was having a Zoom call, but I felt twice. I felt so sick. How long did it?
You are a very lucky guy because you have a gift also for you.
Why is that?
Gary got everything for you.
Oh, thank you.
Are you enjoying your stay at the Splendido?
Yes, a lot. And we're on the beach. Mom's feeling better. It's
way better.
Yeah. So nice. Cheers. So after you get from the beach, there are showers here and there's warm water. Like, this is, to me, I've never experienced something like this, and it's the best thing ever. And I changed into another bikini in the meantime. Okay, so am I the only one who takes another bikini and then changes? I always have one spare bikini, and when I feel like I want to wear something dry, I wear that, and I just feel so good. Mao and his brother always come up with the stupidest bets, but I love them. I think they're fun. Now they are doing this. So Mao has got a glass here, his brother got a glass there, and then if they're gonna see who's gonna be the first one who is able to throw a stone into the other one's glass. And if Mao wins, then Benjamin is going to what?
He's gonna pay for the food.
For the food. And otherwise, Mauritz going to pay, or going to get a bottle of champagne, because this guy, I don't know why, wants champagne. So yeah. Let's see.
Right? Nobody drinks champagne,
but
he wants to drink champagne.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, maar ik geef je de Perrier Chouette, hè? Niet de Dom Perignon. Because nobody drinks it.
Because it's less expensive.
Yeah. Begin maar. Nee, begin maar. Begin nou.
Nope. I think I would be so good in this game, Mao.
Huh? Ja, mag er niet.
Mao, if you let me throw once, I'll get it in. Oh! Oh, it bounced back!
Het telt dat?
Nee.
Oh! People are watching at us like they're crazy. Okay, so nu ga je een hele fles champagne drinken.
Yeah. Okay, now Negin is doing it. Okay.
Oh yeah. Okay, I'm big.
Wat krijg ik mee?
Huh? Ik wil dat je iets geks doet. Wat is iets geks? Nee, ik denk iets anders. Oh, ik denk dat je hier moet staan. En dan als de aap zo doet.
Een aap, dus een wolf. Gorilla. Ja, maar je doet het geluid van een wolf.
Hij is emotie na.
Oké, we have a small break. The food is here. Oh, yeah.
I have to win because when he loses, he's going on the beach like little. How do you call that?
Snail.
A snail. He's gonna walk or crawl like a snail on the beach. So.
On the beach for everyone to see.
I'm gonna win.
Okay, it's Negin against Wally. Wally.
Wally.
Wally the walrus.
First try. Nee, ik zei van de video. I told you well. Yeah. Let me do it. I'll do it in one try.
Okay, ga dan.
Succes.
Ga dan. Okay, Bea. Ah.
Zijn we schieten?
Ja, 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 maar niet spuiten.
Auw! Oh my god! Oh man! I felt like it was gonna happen.
Nee, ik hoef niet. No, I don't.
No, it's only for him. Yes! We are matchy-matchy in Dior, in what we unpacked this morning. I'm getting ready for tonight's anniversary dinner with... Je hebt een gat in je boxers. Oh my god. Anyway, I'm getting ready. I just did my makeup. And I did my hair. I still have to finish it off. But I'm going to... I brought a couple of looks with me. So, you guys remember the tip I gave you last week, right? About the wardrobe tip. And that thing comes in very handy when packing, but also when I don't know what to wear. So let's see. Okay, so the options are this dress that I showed you last week. Oh yeah, so this dress is an option, and this is the back, which is nice. Then this is a, I think a bit too much, because it's like a lot of sequins. It's very nice, but I don't think it's nice for an Italian dinner, so maybe not that one. And I brought another white dress that I think I'm actually going to be wearing. But Mao says that I shouldn't be wearing... Well, I can wear heels, but I should bring slippers with me, right? Like flats.
You should wear slippers and bring heels.
And bring heels, because we're going to walk on a few stairs. Many or a few, Mao?
A few, not so many.
A few, not so many. What are we gonna do? We're going for dinner, right? You organized it. And it's been doing very secretive these past
days.
So I'm kind of nervous.
Our 15 year anniversary, and you have to do something special.
I know, I'm excited. So I'm gonna change now, and then we're gonna go. So, okay, this is the dress, guys. As I was saying, it's pretty tight around the knees, but this is it. Hi, fiance. This is the first time we're making an appearance as fiancés.
Yes.
We've been calling each other fiancé for fun the entire time. Hi, yeah. Fiancé. I am first going to add a few clips, because if you're new and you don't know who I am and you don't know what we're talking about, we got engaged in Portofino last week. We've been together for 15 years, which is a topic that some find very interesting. But I'm first going to show you like a few clips, like the video that I posted on Instagram maybe, and let's do that now.
I found my love in Portofino, perché nei sogni credo ancora, lo strano gioco del destino a Portofino m'ha preso il cuore. Ricordo un angolo di cielo dove ti stavo ad aspettare.
Wanneer was eigenlijk de laatste keer dat we gevlogd hebben?
The last time we vlogged was before we went to the dinner.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So this is like a week later when we just arrived in Ibiza. It was a week. It was like a very emotional night, and like we needed a week sort of
to process.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, to just
and enjoy. Also.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah. So what should we tell?
Maybe I should start how I got the idea.
Yeah.
Of, and you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we never really wanted to get married before.
No, it wasn't like a big thing on our list, right? Getting married or something.
No, and especially Negin. Negin, I wanted to, you know, get married earlier, but then Negin was, you were not like so fond of the idea of getting married.
No.
And then I think that changed during COVID.
Yeah, maybe.
During COVID, your you know, you got kind of into the idea of getting married.
But let me also say that you wanted it at the beginning.
Yeah.
Like maybe in the first few years. And then you were also like, I don't really care that much. Like you never really...
No, because, you know, in the end, you know, we were already living together.
Yeah.
We already have a business together.
We were married. Like people thought we were married. Like the idea of being married, to me, I think that for me, marriage didn't really mean a thing. It's still... doesn't mean a lot, like things are different, like we're still the same in a way, right? We're still as loyal as we were before, we were still as dedicated as we were before. And I always said I couldn't love you more than I already did. Like marriage wasn't gonna make those kind of things happen. I think it was more about during COVID and things we've been going through, and we've been through a lot in the past year, 15 years, and I just really wanted to celebrate the love we have with each other and the family. I think that's the thing that changed. Not about the contract, not about like anything else.
Yeah. So your opinion on marriage kind of changed a little bit. So then I started thinking about, you know, proposal and, you know, when to ask you and stuff like that. And because of COVID, we couldn't travel and I wanted to have like something more special. In the Netherlands, it rains a lot. Also the scenery is not that nice. I wanted to have like a nice, beautiful,
you
romantic
scene. Like on a
scenery.
Farm with like cows and everything.
Yeah, because you like, yeah.
I like them, yeah.
Yeah, you like cows, but she doesn't like dirt and stuff like that, so. But, so, then, last month, actually a trip came up, got cancelled, and then we actually thought about going to Portofino, right?
Can we just say that you really wanted to go to Portofino?
Because I wanted to propose.
Yeah.
And that's when I started thinking about the idea of proposing in Portofino, because it's so beautiful. We've been there once before, like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Really short, like in an afternoon, but it was so beautiful that I thought it was the perfect location to propose. And also because we like Italy so much, Negin loves the food in Italy, me too. I think it's our favorite. So all the things combined really made sense, and I really wanted to do it there and then.
On our
15th anniversary, because it's so iconic, right?
Such
and it's
a
so
moment.
Nice, it's such a moment.
Yeah.
And also, you know, Negin knows that I always organize something nice for our anniversaries,
yeah.
Right?
So let's start with like a few weeks before like our anniversary. It started at home when it was funny because Maris was clearly organizing something. So the few things that I noticed that he was organizing something was first when he once forgot his wallet in the car, so he had to go and grab it. And then the next day he forgot it again. And like an hour later I was thinking, wow, this never happens, and now it happens twice in a row.
But you had there were a lot of things to organize. So you have to get the ring, you have to get the location, you have to get everything. The location has to be decorated. So there's a lot of work into it. So
what I said,
it doesn't have to be, you wanted it to be.
I wanted it to be.
Yeah.
But for me, there was a lot of work going into it. But you had no idea, because I went to the accountant six times.
But wait. Okay, yeah, you went six times, but one time you went and I asked you, he came back and I was like, oh, what did you do? And he was like, I did this and this. And I was like, wait, but we already did that, right? You already did that. And he was like, right? Those were one of the things that
I said, okay, I have to do the annual accounts closing of 2020. And she said, you already did. I'm like, how do you know? Because she never, you know, when it comes to money or finances, you actually never bother, you know, and you never want to know about it.
No. It's funny also because one of the things I noticed as well, when we were in Portofino, one of the first days, he said to me, like one of the first days, he said, okay, tomorrow morning I'm going to go and I'm going to do a workout at like 10. I'm sure, yeah, okay. And then I was like, okay, is he like going to work out or is he like, is this like, part of organizing everything. Yeah, so I was gonna pay attention when he came back to see if he actually worked out or not. I was like, is he gonna take the effort to throw a bottle of water over him in order that it looks like he worked out? And then he came back completely dry.
Yeah, but sometimes I you know, when I work out, I do
you
just
still
like...
still sweat.
Okay, okay.
So when I... But when I then asked him, I was like, oh, huh? But you didn't sweat. He was like, okay, Negin, you know I'm organizing something, right, for our 15th anniversary. And that is something that really, that just made sense. So it wasn't like, oh, he's organizing these things for our engagement, for proposing, but more for, our 15th. But I was hoping for it. Like, I thought it was a perfect moment, but yeah, you didn't know in the end, so.
Yeah. So, okay, then going back like a month before the actual proposal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then going back 3 weeks before, I had to find the ring, which wasn't easy because, you know, I don't know a lot about rings. So what kind of...
He did find the perfect ring though. And I never showed you like a ring that I love, right? Like I never went ring shopping with you or... I never said, oh, I like this engagement ring or I don't like it. So he did it all by himself and it's so perfect.
Yeah, yeah. That was a difficult one. But, and then also the location, you know, I wanted to have the perfect location. And then I had some people in Italy that helped me and we found this beautiful castle on the opposite side of our hotel.
Yeah, and we were looking at it the entire time. And even his brother came over for a few days and afterwards, after the proposal, he told me like that he saw people hanging or putting the lights up. So he saw everything happen and I didn't have a clue of what was going on because I didn't look at the castle that much. It was just like the overall beautiful view we had.
Yeah, but I once told you, look at that beautiful castle.
Yeah,
the name of
did.
The castle, yeah.
Yeah, you told me something about the castle, that's true. Yeah.
And then the night itself, I was so nervous. I couldn't even talk. So we were in the car towards the castle and I wasn't saying anything. And he was like, why aren't you talking? Normally you're talking. And I was like... I couldn't say anything.
That's also what someone said, like, why didn't you talk when you proposed, right?
I said something. I said, do you want to marry
me? Yeah.
But I couldn't get it like a full speech because I was, first of all, I was very nervous. Not whether she would say yes or no. You know, I kind of knew she would say yes.
Yeah.
But then I was also so emotional. So I didn't want to cry because I think that's a little bit lame, you know, on a proposal. But I was.
You cried afterwards, though.
Yeah, a little bit. No.
I'm sorry, that's not the image that Maris wants to portray.
No, that's not my Instagram image. You know, I'm a tough guy.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, very tough. Everyone knows how tough you are.
I broke my nose like 7 times.
That is supposed to show everyone how tough you are. Oh my god.
Of course. Okay, anyways. I don't care. So first of all, you know, when you came in, you didn't know that it was still, you didn't know that it was a proposal, right?
No.
But Anna was there to film everything because I asked her to.
Yeah.
And then we walked towards like the spot where I wanted to propose, overlooking the Portofino Bay. And I told you first, because I had the ring in my pocket, right?
Yeah.
And I needed some time to, because I didn't have, I have the ring in a small
sachet like thing.
A small bag, because I didn't want to put it in a box, because then you would see the box in my pants.
I was looking, no joke, I was curious at his pants to see if there was a box sticking out, so that was very wise.
Yeah, so I had a small bag with the ring in it, but it had also, it was sealed, like there was a string around it. Yeah. So I had to get the string off. But I had to find some time. So first I said to Negin, look down. You know, look down, I have a surprise for you. Look down, there was nothing there. So she was searching and looking, and I had the time to get the ring out of the bag.
Yeah, so I honestly thought that was, and that's also what I thought was for our anniversary, like somewhere that he wrote, I don't know, like, I love you, Negin. But it's typical me, whenever you show me something, oh, look at that building there or there from distance, I can never find it. So I was like, oh, this is typical me, like, he organized something out there and I am not able to see it, and I was really struggling.
Yeah, and that was the right time for me to get the ring.
Yeah.
I went on one knee and I said, do you want to marry me? So I said something.
Yeah, I know.
But I was with the ring, I wanted to happen naturally.
Yeah.
And not too much, you know, thinking about it.
Yeah, it was perfect. It was so nice. And then, because Anna was there, we know she works with us at Gizu, and from the start she's our creative director, but we've known her before, and she's so close to us, so Maurits asked her to come. So I remember when we came in and I saw her and I was like, what is Anna doing here? But then anyway, after the proposal we had dinner, right, and we felt bad that Anna was there, and we're like, oh, come and have dinner with us, and at a certain point she says, you know, guys, I'm gonna say no, because you need that time for yourself. And I'm in the end really happy that she did, because we really needed that time.
Yeah,
it was
together,
like
yeah.
this most special night, also like emotionally, and it was just, I don't know, like 15 years is special.
And then we also called the family.
Yeah, we like also called the family. Yeah.
Hey.
And a bit emotional stuff. It was a really nice night.
It was a really special night.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now we're looking forward to get married, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, about the wedding, we have no idea yet. We know a few things. We don't want to do it necessarily very small with only family, right? We want to do it with everyone we know. Everyone that's close to us,
yeah.
everyone we know. I don't know, just like
not
a big,
everyone we know.
But yeah. like a big party, right?
Yeah.
Then you were thinking Italy.
Yes.
I wanna have.
Because Italy, it has the most beautiful scenery and the best food.
Yeah, that's true. So maybe Italy.
Yeah.
Let's just explore first.
Let's do Italy.
Okay, let's explore first.
Okay, but what would be another option then?
I don't know. I once said Croatia.
That's nice, but I think.
But I don't know.
Okay.
I just haven't looked into it at all. Like, I don't know. I don't even know anything. I don't know anything about the dress or like what you have to arrange. So we'll see. I mean,
what
we're
about
enjoying.
The dress?
I don't know. So we're enjoying this time right now, and then yeah, we'll just see and go along the way.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll keep you guys updated. Oh, one thing I'm looking forward to. Oh, could be another one of those taste tests that we always do. Wedding cakes.
I don't like cakes.
That's what you always say, and then you eat it.
I like
okay,
pasta.
Guys. Anyway.
Wedding pasta.
Wedding pasta.
In Italy.
We can do one of those as well. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. We talked a lot, and I'll see you in the next vlog.
Bye.
Bye.